Flowcare nasogastric tube. The placement of a nasogastric tube is indicated for short-term gastric feeding, maximum 6 to 8 weeks, and for stomach decompression. Consider peg placement in case longer-term application is necessary. Flowcare nasogastric tubes are available in multiple lengths and charrières and are offered with or without guide wire. The tubes are available in PER, silicone and PVC design. PER and silicone tubes are more patient-friendly than PVC tubes because of the softer materials used. Preparation. Prepare the following materials required for placement of the nasogastric tube. Flowcare nasogastric tube, hypoallergenic tape, 50 ml syringe connecting with the tube, small container with water to moisten the tube, glass of water, tape or a marker to mark the correct placement of the tube, small towel, handkerchief. Wash your hands or wear surgical gloves. Placement.
Goedemorgen, Saskia.
If possible, explain the procedure to the patient. Place the patient in a semi-recumbent position. Place a towel on the patient's chest. Measure the required length of the tube by keeping the tip of the tube at the lowest point of the sternum and leading the tube behind the ear to the tip of the nose. Mark the tube at this point with a pen or tape. Submerge the tip of the tube into the container with water. This will facilitate the introduction of the tube. Ask the patient to blow his nose. Choose the nostril through which the patient breathes most easily. Ask the patient to bend his head backwards and introduce the tube into the chosen nostril. Ask the patient to bend forwards as soon as he feels the tube in his throat. Advance the tube further and ask the patient to swallow the tube further down, potentially by drinking small sips of water. Let the patient sigh deeply to prevent retching. Introduce the tube further until the previously applied mark reaches the nose. Subsequently, check if the Flowcare tube is adequately placed in the stomach through aspiration of gastric contents. Measure the pH value of the gastric contents using pH paper. The tube is correctly placed in the stomach if the pH value is below 5.5. If the measured pH value is higher than 5.5, the appropriate tube placement needs to be confirmed through X-ray. The tube is visible thanks to the radio-opaque line. Note the pH value in the patient's medical chart. Tape the tube to the nose, avoiding compression of the tube against the nostrils. After assessing that the tube's placement is correct, inject 20 to 40 milliliters of water into the tube. This will avoid acidification and coagulation of the tube feed, and as a consequence, will avoid obstruction of the tube. In case of using a tube with guide wire, introduce the guide wire completely into the tube prior to placement by pushing the handle of the guide wire completely into the large opening of the feeding connector. Remove the guide wire only after flushing the tube. Care. Work hygienically and aseptically. Care of the nose and mouth are very important. Change the hypoallergenic tape that fixes the tube daily. Clean the skin thoroughly. If the skin under the tape is damaged, remove the tube and place a new tube in the other nostril. Take good care of the damaged skin. Ask the patient to blow their nose on a regular basis. If this is impossible, clean the nose with saline. Even if the patient is not able to eat, it is very important to take good care of the mouth, teeth and lips. Check the position of the tube prior to feeding by measuring pH value of gastric contents using pH paper. At least 3 times a day and with each change of nursing duty. When in doubt, use X-ray to check the position. Flush the tube with 20 to 40 milliliters of water before and after administration of feed or medication, and at least every 8 hours. If the tube does get blocked, flush the tube with lukewarm water. Do not use excessive pressure to prevent tube rupture. Use a syringe larger than 20 ml. Gently squeeze the tube between your fingers along the length of the tube. Do not use any other fluids to flush the tube. Never reinsert a guide wire to solve tube blockage, as this may cause perforation of the gastrointestinal tract. If the tube clogging is not resolved, remove the tube and place a new one. Please read the instructions for use on the packaging and guidelines. Immediately stop feeding and ask for medical help when there are doubts about the patient's medical condition, for example, shortness of breath or abdominal pain. PER and silicone tubes should be replaced after 6 to 8 weeks. PVC tubes can be used for a maximum of 10 days.